never wear my hair in a ponytail, but I think I actually like it. Oh shit, did I even do a title? Stop looking at yourself in the mirror. Okay, so this is going to be about my perspective. This is a disclaimer. This is my perspective on this type of stuff. This is my, what I've deciphered, what I have concluded, my choice to make on what I believe is true, and let me see, hold on. Shit like that. My notes. Okay. So, like I said, this is all my perspective. I studied a lot of things like reincarnation, a lot of stuff that has to do with the zodiacs, like in the Bible times. This is my perspective. Like I said, you don't have to believe it. You don't have to, like, choose to, you know, follow it or, like, believe in it or whatever. However, this is up to you to, you know, to look into it more or whatever. And hopefully it just inspires you guys to just look deeper and find your own perspective and your own answers and things like that. So, like I said, I study a lot of zodiacs and things like that, like this is my favorite book that I got from Goodwill, and I got it a long time ago, and at the time that I got it, it wasn't oh my god, wet. Damn, how the fuck did it get wet? Whatever. Anyways, at the time that I got it, I never really, like, read it. I just got it because I thought it looked cool, and that's what happens with a lot of books that I get. Like, I don't read them at that time. I just find them later when I'm going through the same shit. And I'm just like, I'm learning about the Aztecs. Maybe I should read that book. And then, like, it comes out, and it just, like, makes totally perfect sense. I don't know how it got wet, which is kind of pissing me off. Somebody probably freaking wet it. Anyways, so, like I was saying, so, this book here has a lot to do with, the zodiac signs, and a lot of people don't understand that it's really deep, it's really serious. Like, they knew how to read the stars, and they learned how to, understand, you know, how to predict things, but it's not really predicting when they knew how to piece the information together. It was like smart, you know, like preparation, planning, things like that. And like this one here is galactic synchronization. Let me see about that real quick. See, I never really went through the whole thing, but I think it's just really cool. Like, I started getting deeper and deeper into astrology and things like that, and then, like, the stuff just really started transitioning to the new age. Oh yeah, I forgot, it's backwards. So that's really cool, because I feel like a lot so this is right here, it says significance. It makes the mind reflective, increased spiritual strength, enables the person to cope with change and understand nature. It represents everything that corresponds to the subtle aspects of the human nature. The agriculture calendar begins with this day. So, yeah, I really need to, like, get back into this. But, I think it goes deeper in it. A new enlightenment, your soul shall accept the truth and hold it in high esteem, it will come to pass that you shall adore the divine truth, and the government of our ancestors will stand in readiness forever. This is so fucking cool. I never even seen this shit. Like, I swear, every time I read the book, like, I see new things happen all the time. Anyways, so, like, free will. Like I was saying, I studied a lot, and I listened to a lot, and I researched a lot, and things like that about, like, free will and, like, the zodiac signs, because I think it's really interesting, and that's something that I love to do. Like, I feel like, I don't know, but it's just everything that my ancestors did before me, I end up finding really intriguing, and I didn't even know that they did that. Like, the Mayans and the Aztecs, I didn't even know that they, like, did astrology. Like, back in the days, like, when I first got into it, I wasn't sure that it was even, like, astrology, like, reading the stars. What they did, what I was doing, was what they were doing. And, like, my Nana, when she was doing the tarot cards, like, I didn't know she did that, and I just happened to just do it, you know. I thought it was different from everybody else, but turns out I was just really just doing what was in my, history? I don't know. Anyways, so, like, free will, so I believe that, based upon my research, that, you know, we're given our free will, and we are given, like, before we touch down into Earth and take our first breath, before we take our first breath, this is my perspective, like I said, I believe that our soul has been here for a while, unless we're new souls, it's a whole different story, but we make a contract, and we sign it, and not in that sense, but, like, we choose what life we want to live, right? Okay, and we're like, yeah, I would be good at this, and so, like, you and the Creator and the Almighty are like, okay, well, this is what you gotta do, and this is how you gotta do it, and we're all excited, we're like, yeah, I'm gonna do this, and this is gonna be what I'm gonna be good at, and because I'm familiar with it. And then when we come to Earth and take our first breath, we just forget everything that we ever talked about, planned, wanted to do, and why we even came here. And so, like, with that, we have to kind of figure out what we're here for, what was our soul purpose, like, what are we good at? What is the one thing that keeps pulling at us every single day that wakes us up, that reminds us that we're not doing what we're supposed to be doing? What is our soul purpose? So, like I said, we have this contract that we have to, like, complete and fulfill, and, you know, and, we have choices in life, and we can choose to go one direction or go another direction. Like, when we're made, the Creator God, you know, the bigger life force, whatever, knows that there's gonna be difficult things in this world that, you know, you're gonna have to decipher and choose from. Never deny it. What was I saying? Oh yeah, okay, so everything that was good and also bad, God created. That's what a lot of people misunderstand. Like I said, this is my perspective, and I believe that everything, even negative, is a blessing and is from God. Because what if He's trying to tell you, look, don't do this shit, because if you do this shit, this is what it's going to lead to. And if you choose to understand it, if you choose to learn from it, then, you know, it's a good thing, right? So, like, a lot of people think that negative things and dark forces and this and that is all bad. But don't you think that God created everything? Because He did. He knew exactly what He was doing. There's reasons why things were created. And so, when you're born, like I said, you have this one thing that your soul is just, you just enter life to do, okay? Now, this is my perspective once again. He knew who you, He knows everything, right? He knew everything before it's even planned, okay? So he knew what kind of environment you were going to grow up in. He knew what parents you were going to be freaking born to, which is crazy because I just found out, like, not that long ago, and I have references and stuff if anybody wants to read this stuff, okay? So, it's crazy because my mom is a Cancer, and they said if your mother's sign is 4 away from what you are, so Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, that it's a karmic relationship. And when I read that, I was totally blown away. I was like, because I've been feeling like me and my mother's relationship is definitely a karmic relationship. And that just means like, okay, yeah, so karmic relationship. So he knew what family you were going to be born to. He knew what kind of obstacles you were going to face. He knew what you and your mother were going to agree and disagree on and things like that. So when you're born, you kind of forget everything, right? And so, because if we came to life, if we came to Earth knowing exactly where we should go, knowing exactly what we should do, knowing what our purpose is, you know how easy that would be? Like, we'd just be like, oh, okay, I'm going left, and I gotta take a right here, and yeah, I'm gonna also be this public speaker and talk about God and spirituality and zodiac signs, and yeah, it's gonna be super easy and breezy. And so if everything was easy, then it would be, like, not a test. Do you know what I'm saying? If we knew the answers, then it wouldn't be a test. And so when we pass away, or the choices that we make, if we repent and learn and understand them, then we... Okay, so karma... Wait, let me finish. Okay, so if, you know, at the end of our life, when we pass away and our spirit goes into, you know, another... place, dimension, or whatever, that's a whole nother topic, then you kind of like they say, like, judgment day, you know, you kind of like, it's not necessarily judgment in the way, like, you fucked up this, and you fucked up that, and shit like that. It's not really like that kind of judgment. It's more like a, because God is not like a angry, like, fierce, like, punishing, like, negative, like, mean father that whoops the shit out of you, right? No, like, we do that to ourselves, okay? So that's coming up. But at the end of our life, we kind of, like, go through and say, you know what, this is where I didn't do so right. This is what I needed to work on. This is what I still should have, you know, done better and things like that. And we